What happened that night?
I don't really remember what happened that night, but all I know is like I have blue paint all over my body.
Oh, sorry about that. Was like a regular Friday.
I don't know, but I'm just so happy to be here tonight to celebrate like our 10th anniversary. This is our night. It's so special. Like, oh my God. All about us. I know. I love you.
Thank you.
Sorry.
All right, so seriously, I'm actually going to take this time to talk about Pat a little bit. My buddy. So actually, Pat and I met. I had moved in with a boyfriend of mine, and Pat was one of the roommates. And we were night owls. We both would stay up to like all hours of the night, like 4 hours, like till like 4 a.m. and stuff, and play this stupid game, like this Pictionary game. And
loser.
And we would be sitting across from each other on our laptops, and I would draw filthy pictures and try to get kicked out of this online game. And we would laugh and we would laugh, and I thought it was hilarious. And seriously, I would draw like a dick on an apple. It was awesome. All right, maybe I was the only one that was laughing, I don't know. But it was fun. But then I moved out, and we sort of went our separate ways. I think we had a drink or here and there. And then at one point, Pat actually reached out to me. I think he was having some apartment troubles. He didn't have heat or water or both. And I'm like, all right, just come stay with me. And he brought Dewey, and him and Dewey came over, and I took care of them. I know you're all thinking, how could I take care of anyone? You're probably all right. I just gave them both up. But I think actually at that point Pat was unemployed, and I had to go to work. So I set up some video games and I set off for work. And I came back and Pat was 8 hours later, 10 hours later. Pat was playing the same video game. I'm like, unemployed and playing video games all day? My, have the tables have turned. fast forward like 2 years later, I don't know how long. Where we were at Tony's house first, Tony. A bunch of us were there, and how things go, everyone went to bed, and it was just Pat and I hanging out. And I'm just going to get serious. I came on to Pat. And wisely, he said, "No, gross, what are you doing?" And at the time, I was like, "Are you serious? Resisting this? The Sullivan charm? Are you crazy?" But that's when I knew that this man is a brother to me. And as brothers do, we would be each other's wingmen moving forward. And I remember this one time at the Jamaican Jerk Hut. I accompanied Pat on a reconnaissance mission to acquire Danny. And long story short, at some point I assume Pat moved on, or put a move on Danny, and the rest is history. And throughout that history, I've come to know Danny as a brother as well. So, tonight, my two brothers just got married. congrats, guys. I love you guys. I love you always. I'm going to pass the mic to Jim at this point. Actually, Jim, I just thought of something.
What was that?
This is just amazing. So amazing. This is the first time that Pat has let anyone speak for more than 5 seconds.
Pat, I know. Usually it's like, you know. I mean, can a brother get a minute? But anyway, all right, Danny, it's your turn. It's gonna get a little bit sappy now. Needless to say, no vote yet, it'll be later. Needless to say, I was extremely honored when he asked me to stand for you on this special day. As many of you know, Danny and I have become very close over the years. Danny has literally become the Shirley to my Laverne. Which makes Pat and Kevin Lenny and Squiggy. Anyway, we've been through some good times and some rough times. Like, falling down the steps in the Poconos, drinking a mimosa. Or falling down on the street in the middle of P-Town off of a tandem bike. Or falling down the steps of Pure wearing high heels. Are you all sensing a theme? But seriously though, Danny, you became such a special part of my life, very important. You became my rock, my confidant, my sounding board, my best friend. Woo. And for that, I thank you. However, I did not stand here just for you today. I'm also standing here for you, Pat, my Trish. You two have become my best friend. Although, I would love to smack the shit out of you. Often. I don't know what I would do without a day getting 19 million from Pat. But anyway, hold on. But you both know there's nothing that I look forward to more than coming over on a Friday night, sitting at the Danny and patio, drinking to the wee hours of the morning, talking nonsense, probably smoking about 15 packs in a row. Except for this night, tonight, where I get to stand amongst our amazing group of friends and family, and to witness this perfect union. What you two built is an inspiration, and I hope someday to achieve that. I don't know about Kevin, but I just will say this, I wish you nothing but an eternity of happiness and love and vodka. And with that, Kevin and I would like to ask everyone to raise their glasses. Hey, where's ours? And we're going to give a giant toast to the new Mr. and Mr. Danny and Pat Sanchoa.